स्टूडेंट्स अस्सलाम वालेकुम। नाउ वी हैव रेड द स्टोरी लिटिल फ्रॉग इन द वेल। नाउ वी कम टू द एक्सरसाइज, इट्स पेज नंबर 38, अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंशन। यू हैव रेड द स्टोरी, सो लेट अस डू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। ए क्वेश्चन इज, हाउ मेनी एनिमल्स आर मेंशन इन द स्टोरी? फ्रॉग, येलो स्पैरो, बर्ड्स, एंटीलोप, मंकीज, स्क्वायरल्स। So it means there are total 6 animals that are mentioned in the story. Now come to the B. Why did the yellow sparrow come to the well for 7 days? Yellow sparrow tried to convince the frog that the world is big, world is beautiful outside this well. So he should come out of the well. But frog, he was such a stubborn person, such a stubborn fellow, that he didn't bother about the advice of the yellow sparrow. And on the 7th day, the yellow sparrow picked up the frog and came out of the well. Then to the next C question, did the frog find the world outside big, beautiful, give reasons for both? Yes, the frog, he had been living in his well for the whole of his life. He was born over there and he had been living over there for the whole of his life. He didn't have any idea that the world is so big and beautiful. When he came out of the well, he saw high mountains, big trees. Similarly, he saw the long rivers and oceans. He also saw different kinds of flowers. He enjoyed the scent of the flowers. Then he came to know that he was living in a very dark place, and that was not the whole world. The outside world is very big and beautiful. He enjoyed that world and he started living over there in the outside world, not in the dark well. Do you think human beings also live like the characters in this story explained with examples? Yes. In the answer of this question, you can write that the characters in the story, they behaved like the human beings. Human beings also behave in the same way. We consider the small world in which we are living as if it is the whole world. And we do not want to come out of that narrow circle. But when we understand the big world, the beautiful world that is outside, or when our vision that becomes great, then we enjoy life. So we must have a bigger vision in life when we want to enjoy life when we want to do progress in the world. It is important to have a bigger vision in life. This is the moral of the story also, that we must have a larger vision, a bigger vision in life. So the next question is, write the moral of the story. So the moral of the story is also the same, that we must have the wider vision. Sky is the limit for those people who have the wider vision. Otherwise, we will be living like the frog who was living in a dark, damp place in a well. So the people who have the larger vision, only those people can make progress in the world. Then we come to the vocabulary exercise, how to pronounce the words and how to use them in sentences. Different words are given over there. For example, the first word is imagine. This is a verb. And the meaning of this is form a mental image or concept of. Or to form a mental image. We use this word too much in our daily conversation also. You can make your own sentences. But for example, we can make this sentence like that. Let's imagine that we are traveling towards Mars. Right? Now the next word is shallow. This is an adjective, means a quality of little depth. The meaning is of little depth. You can make the sentence like that. Some fish can only live in shallow water. Next word is moss. Moss is a kind of plant, a small flowerless green plant which lacks true roots and grows in damp places. So it's a kind of plant, and mosses can grow only in damp places. You can make the sentence like that. Mosses can grow only in damp places. Next word is bragged. To say something in a boastful manner or to become boastful. And you can make the sentence like that. She bragged that she will win the competition. Next is stubborn. Stubborn means not to change one's attitude or position on something, or not to change the attitude. This is stubborn. Nobody likes stubborn people. Next is eagerly. This is an adverb to emphasize a strong desire to do or having something, or it means to have the strong desire. Eagerly means I am eagerly waiting for my result. Next word is blink. Shut and open the eyes quickly. Blink of an eye, that is used in the book also. I can do this task in the blink of an eye. Next word is camping. Run with quick, light step through fear or excitement. Gerund or present participle scampering. So ing form is used. Usually it is a verb, and it may be used as a gerund as well as a present participle. That will be discussed in your grammar lessons. So scampering. A deer was camping in the forest. You can use it like that. A deer was camping in the forest. Now let us come to the next. It's page number 39. Exercise of synonyms. Shallow and stubborn. Two words are given. Definition of synonym is also given. The words having the same meanings are called as synonyms, as we have discussed in the introduction of the lesson also. A synonym is a word or phrase that means exactly or nearly the same as another word or phrase in the same language. So when I say that write the synonym, then you have to write in English, not in Urdu. For example, shut is a synonym of close. Some words are given over here. Now read these words carefully. Shallow. The synonyms are empty, flat, hollow, trivial, slight, surface, depthless, inconsiderable, superficial, unsound. Stubborn. There are so many synonyms that are given over here. Adamant, determined, dogged, headstrong, inflexible, persistent, relentless, rigid, single-minded, steadfast, tenacious, tough, unshakable, willful. All these are the synonyms of stubborn. You can find the synonyms quite easily by the help of dictionary, or you can use Google for that also. On internet, you just write the word and you can find so many synonyms that are there. So this is also a way of increasing your vocabulary. So whenever you find a word difficult, try to find the synonyms of that word also by the help of dictionary. Now come to the next thing. This is word positions. Deep. Deep is used for saying or asking the distance from the top. It shows a long way down from the surface. Some examples are given that you can read. The pond needs to be at least 10 feet deep. Noun. The river is pretty deep here. This is an adjective. This is an area of high hills and deep valleys. This is also used as an adjective. How deep is the snow? He had a deep cut on his forehead. I do feel a very deep sympathy for them all. I heard a deep voice on the other end of the phone. There was a beautiful deep red carpet in the room. He fell into a deep sleep. Now concentrate on all these sentences. In some sentences, deep is used as a noun, and in some sentences, it is used as an adjective. So the same thing again. One word can be used as a noun as well as an adjective. So you can't say that this word is just an adjective, this word is just a noun. The same word can be used as a noun as well as an adjective. So the task is also like that, that using the word deep, use it both as a noun and as well as an adjective. Actually, there are so many sentences that are already given over there on this page in which deep is used as a noun as well as an adjective. So concentrate on these sentences. Then we come to the next, that is on page number 40. There is a little conversation that is given over there. Conversation is a small talk, especially an informal one, between two or more people, in which news and ideas are exchanged. Now it is just a reading practice. Read the conversation given below and explain the whole situation in your own words. Situation is going towards the school canteen. Suddenly Shugufta yells. Shugufta: oh no, I think I have dropped my money somewhere. Homa: oh dear, are you sure? Shugufta, pointing towards her pencil box: I remember, I'll put it there. Put it here. Homa: goodness gracious me, I find the lid of your box quite loose. I think the money must have fallen in your bag. Shugufta, turning back: you got a point there, but I must check. Homa: oh yes, why not? They both turn back towards the classroom. So there is a situation and in which there are two friends, Shugufta and Homa. They are going towards the canteen, but suddenly they say, they saw that the money was not there. And Homa, she pointed out that actually the lid of the box, that was the pencil box in which the money was there, that was loose. Perhaps the money had fallen into the bag. That is why they get back to the classroom for finding the money. It's a small conversation that is there. You can do the practice at your homes as well as when the classes will be there. You can do the practice in the classroom also of this kind of conversation. I think it's enough for today. So thank you very much.